Hello my dear friends and welcome to StudyIQ. I'm Joyce Joy and today in this lecture we will discuss about dedicated passenger corridors. So if we look at the current affair, we will see that the government, that is the union government, is considering or proposing to create more number of dedicated freight corridors, that is DFC. So instead of dedicated freight corridors, the government can consider dedicated passenger corridors. So what is the difference between freight corridors and passenger corridors? Freight corridors is where the freight or the goods are moved or transported. Dedicated passenger corridors are through which the passenger traffic is transported. So that is the basic difference. So instead of dedicated freight corridors, the government can consider passenger corridors. So in this lecture we would be discussing what are the benefits of passenger corridors and how it is different from that of freight corridors and what gain it will bring to the government. So we will see how passenger corridors are a better option than freight corridors. So this is very important from your UPSC perspective, especially from your mains examination perspective. If a question is asked on increased proposals and consideration of the union government for the creation of dedicated freight corridors and how freight corridors are challenging and how the passenger corridors can resolve this issue, if such a question is asked, definitely this lecture will help you. So in this lecture we will be trying to analyze how is passenger corridors better option than freight corridors. So let us start with understanding the issues in the working of freight corridors in India. We know that Indian Railways, this is one of the biggest railway systems in the world. We have one of the largest connections or largest network of railways in the world. And Indian Railways transport around 23 million passengers and 3.35 million tons of freights on a daily basis. But the biggest challenge is that the passengers and the freight, both these are traveled or both these are transported on the same track. So this leads to suboptimal usage of the track capacity. This is because the same track is used to transport passengers and also the freight or the goods. So this will create a suboptimal usage of the track capacity. Now if we consider the passenger trains and the freight trains, the passenger trains run at a different speed from that of the freight trains. This is because the passenger trains have more speed than the freight trains usually, and the freight trains are most of the times stopped in order to give way to the passenger trains. So this will lead to a suboptimal usage of the track capacity. So for example, when a freight train waits for a passenger train, the time that is involved, that is a wastage of the capacity of the track. And also these days there are a number of new trains. That means there is an increase in the number of trains and also the increase in the number of passengers. So with this phenomena, the suboptimal usage or the utilization of the track capacity has provided negative benefits. Now when we talk about cross subsidy, what is meant by cross subsidy? Cross subsidy means that the profit of one unit is used in order to run another unit. So that is meant by cross subsidy. And from Indian Railways context, what is meant by cross subsidy? The freights in the Indian Railways are overcharged and the passengers are undercharged. That means for carrying out passenger transportation, the Indian Railway incurs losses. But for transporting the freight, the Indian Railway charges higher amount and therefore a profit is earned by the Indian Railways. Now, what is meant by cross subsidization here? Here, the cross subsidization means that the profit that is earned through the transportation of freights or the goods are used in order to meet the expenses of the passenger traffic. So, this is called cross subsidization. So unless the passenger traffic or the passenger tariff is rationalized, this will incur losses for the government, especially if the dedicated freight corridors are created. So there is no scope for cross subsidy and this will further lead to further losses for the railways. So this is regarding the issues in the creation of dedicated freight corridors. Now moving on to the plan on dedicated freight corridors from Indian government. The idea of dedicated freight corridors were mooted in the year 2006. So the objective of dedicated freight corridors is to generate capacity or substantial capacity for freight traffic, that is good traffic, by developing separate tracks on identified routes. Now we have discussed that the Indian Railways uses the same track to transport the passengers as well as the freights. So the concept of dedicated freight corridors says that different tracks would be created, that is separate tracks would be created on identified routes in order to provide maximum capacity for the goods travel. And considering this, DFCCIL, that is Dedicated Freight Corridor Corporation of India Limited, was created as a separate company under the Ministry of Railways. So the objective of DFCCIL was to develop separate freight corridors or dedicated freight corridors in identified routes in order to build the capacity of freight transport in India. Now at present, two such corridors are under construction. So the first one is Dadri to Jawaharlal Nehru Port, that is the western DFC, and we also have a eastern DFC, that is from Ludhiana to Sonnagar. So these are the two corridors that are at present under construction. Now the cost of construction. The cost of construction of the eastern and the western dedicated freight corridors is currently estimated at around 81,000 crore rupees for around 2,822 kilometers. So the average cost is around 29 crore per kilometer. Now, if we compare this with the average cost of construction of a track by the Indian Railways, it is 10 crore rupees per kilometer. So, this is almost 3 times higher than the cost of construction of normal track by the Indian Railways. So, this is also a limitation. Now, why is the cost much higher? This is because the freight corridors, they are aimed at carrying freight or goods. So, therefore, they are designed in a way to carry or to transport much heavier trains, especially in the eastern corridor. The traffic in the minerals, coals, etc. are very high. Therefore, the heavy trains should be well equipped to carry these goods. So that is why the cost is very high. Now coming to the operational challenges of dedicated freight corridors. First operational challenge is that there is an uncertain demand for coal. This is because now there is an increasing emphasis on renewable energy. So there is an uncertain demand for coal in the future. Now the second operational challenge is regarding the strengthening of tracks. So this is an additional expenditure. So both these are the operational challenges. The first one is, in the future there is an uncertainty that the goods that are carried through the dedicated freight corridors, the demand for those goods can come down. And secondly, there is an additional expenditure adding on to the cost of the operation of freight corridors. So these are two important challenges. Now let us understand how can dedicated passenger corridors address these challenges and how they can prove as a better alternative. So first one, creating a separate carriageway for passenger traffic would be a better option because firstly, there is lesser project cost. We have seen that in the case of dedicated freight corridors, the project cost is almost 3 times high. So the cost of construction would be much lower. Secondly, there would be increased profits. This is because in the beginning of the lecture, we have seen that there is a substantial increase in the number of trains as well as an increase in the number of passengers. So along with that, rationalization of the tariffs will add on to increased profits for the Indian Railways. Now, third one is that this will bring in punctuality in the timings of Indian Railways because a dedicated passenger corridor will help trains to be on time. This will eliminate any interference in the movement of the trains. Now, this also has an ecological impact. It is that by providing dedicated passenger corridors, a lot of traffic can be diverted from road to the railways. So this will bring down the cost of fuels, or this will bring an additional savings to the economy in terms of fuel cost, and also this will reduce pollution. So all these are the advantages of dedicated passenger corridors over dedicated freight corridors. Hello, my